click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in last video we have seen something called as window listener. In window listener class we have seen whenever we are implementing window listeners, we have to implement all the methods given by window listeners. There are around 7 to 8 methods has been given by window listener. So either you have to provide implementation for the same or you can provide empty implementation. But again, you are just increasing the size of your code, and which is not a right way to do the things. So for that, the option for this is a adapter classes, which is being introduced by Java. So basically, in last video itself, we have seen a drawback of listeners. Basically, we have seen window listener, which is having n number of methods, and we have to provide either full implementation or empty implementation for certain methods. Now to avoid it, we are having adapter classes. So what is adapter classes? Adapter classes are the classes who has already implemented the listeners, and it has empty implementation of all the methods which is being there in the listeners. And these adapter classes we can inherit in our code, and we can just have, you know, this we can have only those methods which is required for me to be given some implementation for the same. Okay, so if I want that only window closed event to be handled, so I will be just using adapter class, and I'm going to just override the method window closed. Okay, so that is the way you can have a adapter classes. We will move to the slides now. So adapters are the abstract classes for receiving various events. Okay, so the methods in these classes are empty. Abstract class, they are abstract classes, but it is having methods which is implemented like empty, with the empty implementation. So methods are empty, and these classes exist as a convenience for creating the listener objects. So we don't have to directly implement listener. We can extend adapter classes and provide only those method implementation which is required for you. So we are having the adapters, some examples of the adapter classes. We are having a class called as key adapter, mouse adapter, window adapter. There are many available. We are concentrating on important ones. So key adapter, it's an abstract adapter class which is receiving key events. Okay, we are having mouse adapter, which is abstract adapter class for receiving mouse related events. And we are having window adapter, which is abstract adapter class for receiving window events. So how actually we can do that, we will see through a small demo. So first we will see a recap of the previous program, previous chapter, previous video, so that you can understand why we require adapters. So in previous video, what we have seen the program which was holding Windows related events. So if you see here, I have a class which has implemented window listener. So in window listener, we are having the methods like window closing, window closed, windows open, window confined, deconfined, and activated, and so on. Deactivated, so on. So at a time I just want to implement window closing event, window I want to give only implementation for this method, but I can't do that right directly, because it is the interface, and this interface has to be implemented. Each and every method has to be implemented, even if you are giving the empty implementation. So if you see, unnecessarily you have increased the size of the code, which is not the right way to do. So to handle it, we have having adapter. So I just show you how we have done it. So here, this is window adapter. This window adapter is a abstract class, and this abstract class is having empty implementation for all these methods, all the methods of window listener. Okay, so if I want to give you the slide idea how actually it is. So this class is being like this. I'm having class window adapter. This is a predefined class, but I'm just showing you the signature of it. And this is the abstract class basically. But it can have concrete methods. So which are the methods it is holding? So it is basically having all these methods, okay, and all these methods with the empty implementation. Fine. So now what advantage I'm getting? So whenever I'm extending window adapter, as it is a class, I just override any method of it. So if I want window closing to be overridden, then I can just override it. And I don't have to give implementation for all the methods which I have done it over here. Okay, so only one method I want to implement. So that's why the adapter classes are there. So basically what it is doing, it is handling only window closing event. And based on it, what it is going to do, it is going to exit from the application. So let's check it out. So this particular example is holding window listeners, window adapters. So basically this is going to generate kind of a GUI. Okay. And what will happen whenever you're closing a window, it should close. That event we are going to see in this view. So java.awt and event package we need to import. The class name is E2 window adapter, which is extending frame. So we are having paint method. We already know paint method will get called automatically whenever first time your frame will get create. So within paint, I have set first my graphics object, not object actually, graphic reference. By using graphic reference, I'm setting the environment. So I have set the environment for color. So blue color is being there. Then I've drawn the rectangle, oval, few ovals, then line and the arc. So it is basically making the shape of face. Then I'm having main method where I have created object of the class E2 window adapter. Then I have set the title, size and visibility. And then what I have done is for my frame will act as what now? Source. And window adapter will act as my listener. So for frame, I have add window listener, and that is new my class. So this is the object of my class, which is being there. So what my class is doing, it is extending window adapter and providing overridden window closing method, and which is doing system.exit. So it will close the application basically. So what will happen whenever you're closing the window automatically? Yeah, you have given new my class. So what it will do automatically, this class is going to handle the event. So this class, which is a listener, it will handle window closing, and what will happen, it will just close the window. So I'm just going to compile it. Got compiled. Okay, let's try to run this. Yeah, so basically first time what happened, your frame got created here, then you made it, given the title to it, that is graphics example. You have given the size of it, 300 by 400, you made it visible. Then you have introduced the listener for it, and that is the my class in this case. Now, What happened when you have created the frame, your paint method got called out automatically and it has created this kind of a GUI. Okay, so it has given the color, it has given this ovals, then rectangle, then line and arc and made the face. Okay, now whenever I'm clicking close, what will happen? The source, which is a window, now what will happen? Event will occur. What type of event? Window event will occur, and window event will be holded by whom? Window closing method. So window closing method will take the information related to the event and then it will perform the action. So what action it is performing? It is system.exit. So if you close it, your basically program will stop. Okay. So this is the way you can use window adapter to just having the same functionality as a window listener. But only thing is, in this case, you don't have to provide implementation for all the methods which is being provided by window listeners. Whichever method you require, you just have to override it. Okay. So I hope you understood this particular concept of adapter. Do try out it. If you like so, do share and subscribe our channel.